Creativity can be a messy business. It can be a challenge to organize your thoughts and plan out projects. In this video, I'm going to walk you through an overview of my newest, favoritest app for organizing a messy creative mind, Milanote. Let's start the action. Hey crew, Itah here. Now, if this is your first time watching, this channel is all about the tools and techniques I use to streamline my video business. About a year ago, I was browsing a site called Product Hunt, like you do. I was looking for a new project management tool when I came across this. Evernote for creatives? You, sir, have my attention. Now, if you followed me for any amount of time, you know that I'm a devotee to the getting things done model, and Evernote's been a big part of my GTD practice since 2004. When I saw this quote, I knew I had to check it out. Milanote's tagline is get organized, stay creative. How could I resist? After a closer look at how people use Milanote, creative professionals, filmmakers, it seemed like a no-brainer. Now, on its face, Milanote is a whiteboarding app, but it goes a lot deeper than that. And over the past year, I've started using Milanote to map out my production workflows, build out projects and mood boards for my animations. I even use Milanote to plan these very YouTube videos. Now, this is the first in a series of videos where we're going to take a closer look at Milanote, but before we get too deep into it and into the use cases, I wanted to give you a broad overview. When you first enter into Milanote, you're going to be presented with a blank slate. This is your home board. You have a few options to start with one of the pre-built templates. Milanote provides a variety of templates to get you started, or you can start from scratch. I'll talk more about the templates a little bit later in this video. First, let's look at the core elements, or cards. There are 9 core elements that you can use to build out a board. You can find them here on the left side panel. From top to bottom, the first is the text card. This element allows you to enter text. There are some basic text formatting options. You can also create text elements by double-clicking in the board. One of the things that's unique about the text card is the cloning feature. You can duplicate any element, but with a text card, you have the option of cloning them, which means you can make copies that'll stay in sync. So if you change the text on one copy, it'll automatically update the others. With the link card, you can add web addresses and display a variety of website content. You should also know that if you put a web address into a text card, you'll have the same effect. Next is the to-do list. This is your standard checklist. Now, I still prefer using Workflow to manage my lists, but the to-do list is a convenient way to organize certain ideas and content. You have the ability to add lines. This is a great way for connecting items. The tip of the line will snap to the desired item and link them together. You can also add arrows to show the flow of an idea. Another way you can add a line is by selecting one or more items, right-clicking, and select Connect. The next item is the board element. You can create boards within boards within boards. They function a lot like folders. If you double click on a board, it'll take you into that board and now you have a new, fresh workspace. You can navigate back by using the breadcrumb navigation at the top left. Another thing that makes the board element so powerful is the ability to create shortcuts. If you right click on a board, you can create a shortcut to that board, and then you can nest shortcuts into other boards, either by dragging and dropping or cutting and pasting. For those who thrive on structure, these are columns. These allow you to group items together. Similar to connecting items, you can select multiple items and right-click to throw them all together in a group. Then there's the comment card, where you can leave notes. Now, to be honest, I don't really use the comment card, but I can see where it would be valuable if you have multiple people collaborating on a board. Last but not least, we have the upload options. You have the ability to upload a wide variety of files. I use images and PDFs mostly. You can use the upload button, but the easiest way to add a file is to copy and paste or drag and drop it directly into the board. I mentioned the pre-built templates earlier. In my opinion, these are a really nice source of reference, but the more I use Milanote, the more I find the power in creating your own custom templates. Once you've created a board and you want to reuse it, you can back out of it, right-click, and create a template. Now, when you create a new board, you'll see the options to select from the pre-built templates or your custom templates. Milanote also has a web clipper. This is one of the things that I really think makes this app powerful. It allows you to capture sections of text from a website or images and import them directly into your most recently created board. Now that you've seen some of the basics of Milanote, are you starting to get an idea of how you might use it? Let me know in the comments. If you're starting to see the potential in adopting something like Milanote, you're gonna wanna subscribe and hit the bell for updates. Because in the upcoming videos, I'm going to be showing you some of the use cases and different scenarios for Milanote, starting with how to map a workflow.